does she like comics?
Oh, Lorraine, I love them with my whole heart.
Hello and welcome. Today is Valentine's Day and we are feeling the love.
Or maybe you just love to feel literally anything. Because I don't love Valentine's Day, Lorraine. It's not really my thing.
Yeah, spoken like a true single person.
Ah, yes, there it is. Cat's out of the bag. All right. Well, you know what? Some of us did not just recently get engaged.
Oh my God. Thank you for noticing. Oh my gosh. Oh, my hand is so heavy.
Unsubscribe. Not to the show, but to that.
No, fine.
No.
You know what, Langston? I just want you to know, though, for real, mm-hmm. you are an independent man.
Thank you.
The holiday does not define you. You do not need a woman.
Thank you.
You do
okay,
not need...
Okay, your check's in the mail. Relax, okay. It's fine.
I just want you to know I support you.
I know, thank all you. Right. Well, listen, I mean, look at the Marvel Universe, right? It's not all fun and romance.
Oh, God, no. Mm-hmm. No, people are constantly breaking up or they're just single.
Mm-hmm.
Real single.
I know, listen, some of those relationships have been broken up by things like, you know, the devil.
True.
Looking at you, Peter Parker, Mary Jane.
Yeah, what's going on with that? Mm. Also, romance is not easy in the Marvel Universe. It is so complicated. Just look at all the love triangles, because I love a love triangle.
Oh, come on, who doesn't? All right, so what's your favorite?
Oh, Jean, Cyclops, Wolverine.
Don't like it. No, that's not a love triangle. Cyclops and Jean were happily married, and Wolverine tried to just come in and ruin it.
Yeah, that's what love triangles are, right?
No, like, I mean, that's just a jerk ruining a relationship in my mind.
Yeah, well, that's how I feel about Emma Frost. Get out of there, Emma Frost. Take your diamonds with you.
No. Diamonds are fun. Diamonds are great. But
no.
You know what's not great? Wolverine perching on Cyclops' bed at 8 o'clock in the morning. Hey, get out of my room.
Okay, what about you?
Well, I really love Reed Richards, Susan Storm, and Submariner because, he's a hunk.
He's a hunk, and he wears nothing but like little trunks.
Yeah, constantly coming out of the surf. It's great. But then also, it's mainly him just carrying Susan Storm to the ocean and like running away. It's always fun just seeing the other three dudes like, give her a hand, come on, quit it. Well, how about Human Torch, Crystal, and Medusa? Because yikes, those are sisters. Rookie move, Mr. Torch.
Oh, you know, people talk. Anyways, tell us which love triangle is your favorite in hashtag Earth's Mightiest Show.
Or which character you want to ruin your relationship. Also hashtag Earth's Mightiest Show.
There you go. There is clearly more than enough romance to go around in Marvel Comics. So in honor of Marvel's 80th anniversary this year, we are taking a look back with this You Don't Know Romance.
Enjoy.
You don't know romance?
Don't you worry.
Let's roll it on back and take you from no game to romance comics explained.
As for dating advice, you're on your own.
All right, here we are in the early days when Marvel was still known by its predecessors, Timely and Atlas.
It was the 1940s and 50s. Big bands were alive and well, rock music was in the process of being born, and comics of the time had something for everyone.
From hilarious animals like Ziggy Pig and Silly Seal, to cowboys like the Rawhide Kid, there was plenty to love, but none felt the love like romance comics.
The genre of these comics encompassed highly varied tales like My Love, Teenage Romance, and Love Romances. Okay, they were pretty similar.
Women were at the forefront of these stories. Heroines like Career Girl in the Big City, Millie the Model, and aspiring teenage starlet Patsy Walker even got their own self-titled comics. Well done, ladies!
The many girls and women of romance comics had laughs, pined, dated, fell in love, married, and next came the baby and the baby carried? That worked better in my head.
And while there was plenty of love, there were even more tears. So many tears. Happy tears, sad tears, angry tears.
Oh, and so many kisses. Happy kisses, sad kisses. Not really any angry ones.
But as the 1960s ushered in the burgeoning women's movement, stories like romance comics that relied heavily on antiquated gender roles went quietly into the night.
But our nostalgic enjoyment remained. And now you do know romance. So what did we learn, Langston?
I learned that romance comics have been around for decades.
Yeah.
That's what I learned.
You know nothing about love, though.
Not about romance, no.
All right, we'll keep working on it. I know what's going to help. Dating profile.
Mm-hmm.
Let's set one up for you. There are tons of human beings across the world.
Okay, well, what could one more hurt? Well, listen, while I follow Lorraine down this bad idea rabbit hole, why don't you guys check in with our own Angélique Roché, who caught up with D’Arcy Carden from The Good Place and Barry.
Oh yeah, maybe she'll even find a soulmate for her character Janet, maybe a robot even.
Ooh.
Oh, speaking of which, how tall are you and would you date an android?
5'11" and yes.
Hi guys, I'm here with the hilarious and multi-talented D’Arcy Carden. D’Arcy, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
People know you as a writer, an actress, a comedian, but I know that you're actually a huge Marvel fan.
I am.
How did you get into our universe?
I first started dating my husband. He was not my husband at the time. He is a huge comic book nerd. He would be like, here's what I'm reading right now, and explain it, and then I would be like, tell me more, and then what, and then what, and then who, and then what happened, and then this. I think I've like seen every Marvel movie ever made. I wonder if that's true. I really think I have. We usually go opening night. We used to be like big midnight, like the night before it comes out, but now we are old, and so we don't do that as much.
Speaking of fans,
yeah,
there are lots of fans out there that probably know you best from playing the many iterations of Janet
right
on The Good Place.
Myself.
Did you know when you landed the role that there were going to be so many iterations of this one role?
I definitely did not. The first season was so secretive, and Mike Schur, the creator, was so secretive, and we wouldn't really know what was coming. I remember the first couple episodes just being like, okay, this is gonna be a challenge. It was just a new type of thing that I had not done before. And then quickly, even like within halfway through the first season, I was like, oh, okay, so I get to do a lot of stuff.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah.
Speaking of a lot of stuff, bad Janet, neutral Janet, good Janet, who wins for you?
Okay, well, I really have a very soft spot for regular old Janet, Janet proper. Playing bad Janet is like a joy of my life. It is so fun. I mean, I only do her in like small spurts. I've never done like many, many days in a row of bad Janet. Let's do that, y'all. Let's do that. Let's do a whole season of bad Janet. I'm putting that out there.
Well, Janet is just one part of your life. You also have been on a number of shows, including HBO's Barry.
Love it.
As well as you are a regular at the UCB in LA.
Yeah.
How do you balance the different characters?
Oh, I think because I do improv, which is the like style of comedy that I do at the Upright Citizens Brigade, you know, you go from scene to scene like with a fully new character. That might be like where I got my chops. There's so many difficult parts of this weird job, but that is a part that's not too hard.
Thank you so much for making the time and coming to play yourself. Thanks so much, this has been fun.
So fun.
You know what else is fun?
Tell me.
A quiz.
Okay.
Are you in for a quiz?
Yeah, I am.
All right.
I'm nervous.
We've got a special Marvel-themed quiz for you.
Okay.
We love AI.
Yeah.
We love robots.
Yeah.
You've heard enough stories. We are literally goo-goo for robots here at Marvel.
Yeah.
And there's lots of robots in the Marvel universe. So we're gonna find out today, who is your robot soulmate?
Okay, oh my gosh, I'm
so Are you here for this? Are you here for this?
Yeah. Okay. I'm nervous.
Question number one.
Okay.
How do you like to spend time with your friends? A, we team up and go on adventures. B, chat via the internet. C, run away to avoid adults. D, you have no friends. There is only doom.
I think A, run away and have adventures. I just got back from Costa Rica with 11 friends and we went on some adventures.
How do you feel about humans? A, I love them enough to marry one. B, they're cruel and judgmental, but I can tolerate them.
Mm.
C, I am human. I mean, basically.
Mm.
D, they're all inferior, except Doom.
Wow, I love this. I think this is another A.
How do you approach an argument? A, arguments don't faze me, I move right through them. B, I'm harsh and mechanical, but I'm working on my feelings. C, I never lose my head. D, there are no arguments, there are only orders.
I like this D person. This D person is not me though. What was the second one again?
I'm harsh and mechanical, but I'm working on my feelings.
Yeah.
What's your love language?
Okay.
Shouting from the rooftops when I need to adjust my vocal volume. Showing love through sacrifice again and again. Unsure, I don't know if I've been in love yet, but I've definitely been in like. And D, love is for inferior creatures.
Oh, D. No, not D. I'm like, oh, D, classic D, always saying D things. I think it's A.
You've made this pretty easy
for me. I didn't mean to.
It's totally good. Your soulmate is Vision.
Okay, you know what? I knew it was gonna be.
Yeah.
I really knew it was gonna be.
He's a caring being.
Yep.
He adapts to his partner's needs.
Yep.
And even if you have walls up, he'll phase right through this.
Although I didn't answer the one about sacrifice. He would be the sacrificer, right?
No.
Oh, no?
B was the soulmate was Jocasta.
Oh, interesting. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Cool, Vision, hell yeah.
Vision, great.
Vision!
Thank you so much for doing this. This has been a blast.
Thanks for having me.
So Langston, which robot was your soulmate?
I got Jocasta.
Oh, that's good.
It's fine. I mean, her father is a murderous robot, Ultron, but...
But if it makes you feel any better, he's her father, but also her husband.
That makes me feel infinitely worse, Lorraine.
We'll keep working on it.
Yeah, we have to.
All right, tell us which robot is your soulmate with the hashtag #IsMightiestShow, or leave us a comment on our YouTube or on our Facebook page.
We'll see you next time.
I'm Lorraine.
And I'm Langston.
And this is Marvel.
Your universe.
Oh, you got an update.
Yeah.
They want money.
Give me a break.
Thanks for watching Earth's Mightiest Show. If you like this, then like this and subscribe to the Marvel channel.
Or click the box over there to watch our last episode.
So you're just gonna swipe left or right?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Medusa.
Not a match.
Crystal.
Not a match.
See?
Nope.